Blackstone Publishing presents A Brain for Business, A Brain for Life. How insights from behavioral and brain science can change business practice for the better. By Shane O'Mara. This book is read by Mike Cooper. Preface. In the course of the journey we are going to undertake in this book, I invite you to open your mind to a whole variety of possibilities that discoveries in the modern brain and behavioral sciences have provided us with. I invite you to take advantage of these discoveries and to attempt to use the knowledge that you've gained to make your workplace, your organization, a kinder, gentler, and above all, a smarter place to work in. Neuroscience, the science of brain and behavior, has emerged as one of the key and exciting sciences of the 21st century. It is the science that explores the mechanisms that create you as a thinking, feeling, and behaving individual, and of us as humans. In this book, I gather together adaptive and practical insights from behavioral and brain science to changing business and business practice for the better. Overall goal of the book: to bring adaptive and practical insights from brain science to change business and business practice for the better. Why? Because the brain matters in business. Without a brain, you have no business. The brain is the most complex structure in the known universe. The brain is responsible for each of us being conscious, being able to think, feel, and behave. The brain is also profoundly plastic and can change for the better or worse as a result of experience. Underpinning vision of the book: applying recent research on brain function and behavior to people within organizations and workplaces, and especially knowledge workers. Our brains have many biases, heuristics, and predilections, and we know more about how to work with these than ever before. Behavior change is hard. Adopting tactics and strategies that are well-founded in the science of brain and behavior can help individuals and organizations to adapt to the demands of the modern world. Hoped-for impact of the book: redefining the way businesses incorporate brain sciences into their culture, strategy, and operations in a measurable and reportable way. Additionally, to provide a focus for generating new capabilities and ideas of significant commercial value to participating organizations. We will attempt to extract from the vast body of data that has been generated in the behavioral and brain sciences over the past few decades, applications and findings of specific use and application to business practice, development, and management. Many conventional treatments of organizational life, broadly conceived, ignore those aspects of human behavior that are founded on the shared similarities of brain structure and function between individuals. Our starting point arises from the simple reality that our behavior arises from the structure and function of our brains. We then proceed by examining a series of brain-based, neurocognitive analyses of common aspects of human behavior relevant to business and management practice. The range of topics being actively researched within neuroscience now is quite remarkable, and neologisms are appearing to label the research effort responsible for the fusion of these topics. Neuroeconomics, for example, is emerging as an important discipline, as the science is concerned with brain function, decision-making, and evolutionary psychology, particularly those aspects of evolution concerned with altruism and altruistic behavior, all begin to merge within a common theoretical framework. Social neuroscience is another new and important endeavor that seeks to understand how social behavior is generated by the brain and how the brain manages and is changed by social interaction. The wonderful catchphrase, "from neurons to neighborhoods," has been used to summarize this new science, investigating the social brain. Caveat emptor. I define neuroscience here as the science of brain and behavior. A reasonable and not uncommon reaction among some neuroscientists is to say that there is no overlap between neuroscience and business. Nonetheless, there is some gap in the market for ideas and practices being filled by people who offer services in neuromarketing, brain-based leadership, and the like. Some will object and say that much of what passes for neuroscience in business is actually psychology, which, in and of itself, is not particularly a deep problem. The problem, in this case, is more one of the appropriate label. The definition I offer emphasizes brain and behavior, and it is one that explicitly disparages a silo approach to the creation and generation, and indeed application, of new knowledge. The phrase brain and behavioral science captures this repudiation of a silo-based partition of knowledge pretty well. An analogy might make things clearer. It's likely that you, as the reader of this book, have purchased a car, or a computer, or even a simple mechanical device such as a bicycle. Most people, not all, but most, want to know more than where the driving position is, steering wheel and brake or whatever. They want to understand what goes in the engine, in addition to being able to drive the car. They want to know the optimal fuel to feed the car to power it appropriately. This important sense of having some knowledge of what the brain is and how it functions under particular circumstances can be both enlightening and useful. Having respect for the performance constraints of a car's engine, driven by some knowledge of how that engine works, is useful to every driver. So it is with the brain. It is responsible for generating cognition, for generating mood, for generating behavior, and the attempt to place a neat dividing line between the knowledge of one discipline and another in the interests of some form of disciplinary purity is entirely contrary to the spirit of human inquiry and an ethos of interdisciplinarity. The choices presented here regarding the topics to be presented and discussed focus on areas where we have some understanding of the underlying brain mechanisms and some understanding of the cognitive or other mechanisms that are present. The balance varies depending on the focus of the particular chapter. We will see, for example, that understanding the brain's mentalizing network provides an astonishingly useful rubric for how we, as humans, engage in person perception and brand perception. In other cases, the dual focus on brain and behavior is less strong. This is particularly so in the case of behavioral design for debiasing judgments about others. No doubt, however, in another few years' time, some useful and interesting experiments will have been conducted that provide a blend of behavioral and brain levels of analyses. Where knowledge in a particular area is incomplete, it simply indicates that there is a research agenda to be tackled. It also means that when you, as a reader, encounter particular claims regarding applications of brain science within business, some skepticism may be appropriate. And a toolbox for skeptical thinking is...
We hope you enjoyed this preview. To continue listening to this audiobook on Google Play Books, use the link in the video description.